I want to go back to also what you were saying just a second ago about the money being invested, you know, by the Me Toos or the companies that now are trying to get on the same playing field. Yeah. And there's a quote, and I know you've probably heard it from Steve Jobs about innovation. And he says, it's not about money, it's about the people you have, how you're led, and how much you get it. What does that mean in terms of what we've been talking about?
Yeah. I think people ask a lot about Steve Jobs relative to innovation, I think Steve's, there are multiple, people also say about Apple that they don't believe in talking to customers. They believe in that old Henry Ford, if I asked people what they wanted, they'd say a faster horse. And I think that's absolutely right. You're not supposed to ask people what they want. In that sense, you're supposed to understand the outcomes they're trying to achieve. But if you indeed ask them, what do you want, they're going to say, faster horse. But Steve was good at a few things. First of all, he just personally had a deep sense of what life should be about, if you will. His meditation, his Zen, work. He deeply took in things that matter to us, and things like simplicity and beauty, and he was firm that those things should exist in the solutions that his organization provided. So I think he didn't get that from talking to people like you and me. He got that from a deeper sense of sort of the human condition or human nature, if you will. But he held that deeply. Daniel Goleman talks about the focused leader. Mm-hmm. You need to have inner focus, mm-hmm. other focus, mm-hmm. and outer focus. Steve clearly had inner focus. He had very deeply held beliefs that he, second thing that he did then, was he was willing to put a stake in the ground and say, let's go for it. So a Macintosh on every desk, right? He didn't always get it right, right? So next computer doesn't exist anymore. He learned from it and he carried that forward when he went back to Apple. But Pixar, there were a whole bunch of mistakes made in the evolution of Pixar after he took over the organization. So he did the iPod. That the sales on that were flat for a very long time before he put the iTunes ecosystem around it. So his willingness to say 1,000 songs in your pocket, right, outcome that you can all imagine wanting to achieve, and then put that stake in the ground and stick with it mm-hmm. while he was learning what worked and didn't work, right? The third thing was his willingness to break down barriers, right? So he would say, oh, well, we can't get music. Well, we need it, so we're going to get it. So how do daddies go out there and actually do that? So, you know, those are the things that I think. And he surrounded himself with people who were willing to buy into that vision and were willing to work with him to make it happen. And so I think that's when he talks about it's the people you surround yourself with, right? That's a piece of.
And you were one of those. I know you knew him personally. You could probably share some wonderful stories about Steve Jobs. So you're speaking from personal experience of.
I got to watch the start and ultimately demise of Next. So where he put a stake in the ground and so fully believed in it. Here's how far his aesthetics, so he insisted that all of the equipment in the factory that made the Next computer be painted the same color. So he would issue paint, where he had people issue paint to the vendors of that equipment. And the factory was stunning, it was gorgeous. But that's the level at which Steve operated. He had this deep sense of what things should be. And then he made sure that every detail of that was executed. So if you think about things like your experience in the Apple store now, mm-hmm. when you buy an Apple product, the salesperson stands next to you, swipes your card, and someone else brings the product out of the back of the store. So that the entire time, you're not standing there by yourself saying, ooh, I just swiped my card for X hundred or X thousand dollars. That you're standing next to somebody who's saying, what are you gonna do with your new computer? How are you gonna use it? This is design at the absolute detailed level, right? It's like, this is the experience you wanna create. And it takes attention to that level of detail to create that experience.